Back diffusion explained. An introduction to the concept of back diffusion and its effect on achieving remedial targets. An initial release of contaminants may cause subsurface pollution of the groundwater. The movement of the impacted groundwater can spread the contaminant plume through the more permeable, mobile porosity in the subsurface. Contamination will then move into the immobile, low permeability zones through forward diffusion. Pump and treat will result in mass removal from the high permeability zone only. The residual contamination in the low permeability zones will drive back diffusion, recontaminating the mobile porosity. During the initial release, all contamination is located in the high permeability zone. The concentration gradient then causes forward diffusion of the contamination into the immobile porosity. Pumping only removes mass from the high permeability zone, which is then recontaminated through back diffusion from the low permeability zone. Further pumping results in some mass removal, however, this is followed by rebounding concentrations due to back diffusion. This process repeats, preventing remedial targets to be achieved. Once loaded with contamination, the low permeability zone will provide an ongoing secondary source of contamination. This will back diffuse into the mobile porosity and prevent remedial targets to be achieved through mass removal. To find out how Regenesis offers technical solutions to overcome the challenge of back diffusion, please get in touch or visit regenesis.com.